More and more politicians are actually toying with the idea. In the book of that Hillary Clinton wrote after her defeat, she mentions the fact that she hesitated to propose something like a basic income based on the Alaskan model, because in Alaska, so it's a bit different. It's again a bit different, but all the benefits that come from natural resources are equally shared at the end of each year with everybody in the population on an equal basis. So, but then the money you receive depends on how successful the fund was in a given year. So it's not something that is really stable, that you can anticipate. And so, but she wanted to reproduce that model and to do it on a larger scale in the US, as was already originally intended by Richard Nixon, because negative income tax was already discussed in the 70s. And so she hesitated, and then she saw that the numbers didn't square, that it was not financially sustainable, and so she gave up, and she expressed her regrets for, for doing so. And she thought, and I think it's part, you know, of the political equation that liberals or centrist parties have to promote their own radicality in the face of populism. We have to be radical as well. And so that sort of idea is something we have to seriously put on the table. So Hillary Clinton was, you know, tempted and told with it. In France, a number of politicians have expressed their interest, at least for the question. Our president recently announced a sort of basic income, but it's not a basic income because it's still very conditional, but used the expression, which which shows that it's something that's clearly progressing. And that's progressing now and not, and why is it progressing now and not, you know, two centuries ago when Paine was writing? Well, first of all, because our social systems are already well developed. And in fact, I mean, at least in France, we have so much redistribution already that we could do it by channeling the funds differently, but not increasing significantly the fiscal pressure, for instance. So the money is already there, if you want, which was clearly not the case two centuries
maybe
ago.
You could even reduce it if you simplify a lot.
Yeah, possibly, but it's still very costly. I mean, but yeah, at least could be neutral. And then also politicians are worried about job disruption due to technological innovation. Personally, I don't think it's a good argument for basic income, but clearly it's an argument that is now widely discussed. And that explains why basic income is so popular nowadays.